One of the things you need to know if you're going to fly frigates in faction warfare low sec is what types of fits are common in the meta. If I see a Tormentor or an Atron or a Rifter on D-scan, and I'm trying to decide if I should engage in whatever I happen to be flying, I need to think about how will he be fit? How fast will his ship be? How tanky? What kind of damage? What kind of tracking? What kind of range? And one way to gain this knowledge is fly around faction warfare low sec a bunch. But my idea for this next set of videos is to use Pypha and go over the common fits I expect to see when I'm looking to engage some frigate in novice plex in faction warfare. I will generally assume that they are fit in one of the more common ways, and then when we engage, I will try to look at the various information I'm getting to see, was my guess correct, or are they flying something else? And if they're flying something else, I will try to adjust my plan, whatever it might be. For this video, I'm going to focus on the Amarr fits and go through the combat, attack, and faction frigates the Amarr have available to them. And we're gonna start with the Tormentor. The Tormentor has 10% reduction in small energy turret activation cost, 5% bonus to small energy turret damage. One of the things to know when you're thinking about Amarr ships is that for small weapons, beams tend to be stronger than pulse lasers. You get fantastic damage out of beams. They have, of course, tracking problems as all long-range weapon systems do. But for doing damage at like 8 kilometers, it's real hard to beat beams. They're extraordinarily cap hungry, which is why the Tormentor's bonus to energy turret activation costs is helpful. It'd be pretty rare to put beams on a hull that did not have that bonus. So like most ships in faction warfare, we're going with Afterburner, Scram, Web, because of the way plexes work. If you're already in a plex, you know your opponent's coming in, can try to get the scram, so people tend to fit micro warp drives less, and the fighting all happens within the 9 kilometer scram range, or mostly happens within the 9 kilometer scram range. We do heat sink, damage control, SAAR. It's pretty standard if you have 3 lows to do a damage mod, a damage control, and an SAAR if you're gonna armor tank. And then we have almost no CPU left, and we got to decide what are we going to do with a low slot despite not having hardly any CPU. The main options we would think about are the adaptive nanoplate for tank and a nanofiber for speed. And then we've got the rigs in the low, and you can do different things in this setup. I've opted for a Tech 2 damage rig. This fits heavily reliant on doing a bunch of damage. It's not super mobile. It's not super tanky, but it does really good damage at 8 kilometers. And then the Tech 2 damage rig uses 300 of our 400 calibration and traversal bulkheads that give us more hull HP are 50 piece. And so that uses up all the calibration, gives us a little more buffer tank to work with. Lots of fits use small traversal bulkheads because they give you more buffer tank to get your reps off without slowing you down in the same way that the Trimarks would. Trimarks have a speed penalty, range control is a big deal. I'll show all of the fits with a heated afterburner guns and SAAR because most frigate fights will be of a length that heating for the whole fight is totally practical. So what does all this jazz get us? We end up with 3.63k buffer. You can see how it's distributed. Very little in the shield, some armor, some hull. Hull is almost as good as armor. Like, it's scary to bleed it, but as long as you have some hull or armor, you're not dead yet, and you can keep getting off reps. Like a big fleet fight, you would care a lot more about having the armor because people could swap to you and then swap back. But it's just you and your opponent. Fight's gonna last about a minute. If you bleed a bunch of hull, but you get your reps off, you're in good shape. 3.63k total buffer. the shield is a lot less valuable than the armor and the hull. And then if we get all 8 pasted reps off on the heated SAR, we have 2.88. So the total EHP between the two, 6.5-ish, not amazing, not terrible. Next we come to the damage. The damage is fantastic. We've got 206, again, assuming perfect skills, 206 from the guns and 39 from the 10 megabits of drone bandwidth. We're using 2 hobs, you get about 20 damage per hob for a total of 245. I like to think of 250 DPS as sort of a magic number. Right around there, your opponents tend to not get all that many SAAR reps off. It's hard to rep through 250 damage. And you can see we've got an SAAR and it's only repping about 100. So you'll be bleeding with this setup. If it fought itself, it would be bleeding through hull and armor the whole time it's trying to rep. You'll get some, right? There is some buffer there. If this ship fought itself, you would want to make real sure not to start the reps late. The big weak point of the ship, like I said before, is the tracking. With a tracking of around 100, if a fast frigate gets a tight orbit around you, you're mostly going to miss. So you fight something like an Atron, it gets on top of you, tight orbit. That'll be the fight. You got to kill them before they get to you, which with the damage, it's possible. Something slower, it's a lot easier to get off enough damage before they close with you. This fit is very strong against things that are sitting 8 kilometers away, much weaker against things that are on top of it, orbiting. If you're going to fight it, you need to be in a position where you can either get that tight orbit, or if you think you're not going to be able to get there, you need to be able to trade with it at scram kite range. So something like Republic Fleet Firetail with Artie can trade with it at range. Something like an Atron can close. Something like a Merlin, let's say single web Merlin, real slow. If you start out at 8 kilometers, you're absolutely going to get dunked. Start out on top of them, maybe a bit better chance. Double web Merlin, lots of range control, maybe better odds there. When I see a Tormentor and D-scan, I assume it's going to be a fit like this. Every single fit we look at, if it's got a scram, you could drop the scram and go double web. That gives an enormous amount of range control. But of course, they can warp off whenever. Tormentor with double web is very, very hard to fight. It's very strong at its chosen range. Getting on top of it, establishing the tight orbit is probably the best way to fight it. Real hard to do in time with double web. In most things, if I warp in on a Tormentor and I discover he's double web, I just leave. There are things that can fight it, but you want to be something that's going to do a lot of damage out at scram range, because the combination of the range control from the double web and the big DPS out at scram range makes it real hard. Next Amarr combat frigate is the Punisher, which has, again, the same energy cost, turret reduction, and also bonus armor resistances. Every Punisher in faction warfare space is fit like this. Small autocannons, because they don't take a whole lot of fitting. Tons of tank. It is just an absolutely incredible tank. I hate the Punisher as bait because it's so commonly bait, and because with only 2 mids and plates and a mediocre speed, it can't hold anything. So you go to attack the bait Punisher, you're very obviously not damaging it. You watch D-scan, the friends show up, and you just leave. I would personally much rather bait with something like a Breacher if I was going to do it. The Breacher is tanky, can last a while, it's fast. It could conceivably fight you solo, so you're expecting to fight the Breacher. You're maybe planning on it being you versus the Breacher, and then a friend shows up. The bait Punisher is so common, everybody's looking for the friend, and the Punisher can't hold them because it's only got the 2 mids. So I don't think that makes sense. What's especially weird is you can set up a Punisher that does good damage and has a good tank. You don't even need friends. If they're willing to hang out on grid and you can't hold them anyway, why not kill them yourself? Nobody does that. They're all bait fit. I will often poke the bait fit Punisher if I'm in something fast to see if I can then kill their backup when it shows up. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. But this is what I expect to see when I see a Punisher on D-scan. The attack frigates are faster, generally do less damage, and are less tanky than the combat frigates. The Amarr attack frigate is the Executioner. Typical Executioner would be fit something like this. Beams, empty utility high, the sort of trinity of AB Scram Web for range control, and then the sort of normal damage control, damage mod, SAR. We again have Tech 2 damage rig. One of them increases rate of fire, and one of them increases raw DPS rate of fire. Makes your cap a bit worse, but adds a little more damage. I mostly think it's worth it. And then again, the bulkheads for a little more buffer. Our buffer's pretty sad. We will not last real long, tanking much damage. 2.88 buffer, 2.33 in the SAAR. So total EHP is coming in at a little over 5k, which is pretty modest. That said, the speed is pretty good. And so we can use the range control and get into position on brawlers that can't project out to us. Let's say you're fighting an Incursus. Let's say you're fighting Single Web Merlin, that sort of thing. The blasters don't have a ton of projection, and the damage is a little less than the Tormentor we looked at, but it's still very respectable. I've got to turn that off to get an honest comparison. Still, you know, very respectable damage. It's not quite in the crazy broken, they're not getting any reps off range, but, you know, if they have blasters, they're going to be doing something like 100 damage out at 8 kilometers, even with Void loaded, you know, unless they're a hull that has a range bonus. And so, despite the fact that our EHP is relatively modest, we're going to burn through them pretty fast. Executioner, very engageable. You could also fit it with Pulse. So the big problem with Pulse is that the tracking is not that great. Blasters have quite a bit better tracking. They're sort of the A-tier brawling weapon. And so if you end up in a fight with a blaster ship and they're moving around, orbiting you or whatever, you're going to get a lot less hits if you have pulse lasers compared to the blasters. And because beams are so good and so common, maybe their default strategy against a Mars ship would be to try to orbit you. With something like the Tormentor, it's real slow, it's easier to do. The Executioner has better speed, so maybe you can position yourself. You can get decent damage out of the pulse lasers, less than blasters, and the tracking's worse, but it's all right. And then you can also get okay damage at Scorch Scramkite range out of Scorch, and so you could fly a Pulse Executioner against slower stuff that did not have a double web, with the plan of orbiting with multi-frequency if they're a Scramkite ship, or Scramkiting them with Scorch if they're a brawling ship. If I see an Executioner on D-Scan, my expectation is that it'll be fit something like one of these, and I'm happy to fight it if I, one, think I can get close to it with some high damage weapon system for a little while, or I can trade with it at Scramkite range, which I think is pretty likely. I'm not super worried about them getting a tight orbit and brawling me. In most things, you know, if you're in a Tormentor, I guess that would be a risk. But really, with the more modest tracking, I'm a lot less worried about it in general. If you decide to fly something like this, one nice thing is the Executioners are very engageable. Everybody will fight an Executioner. It's not super threatening. There's only one attack frigate. The faction frigates are the Imperial Navy Slicer and the Crucifier Navy Issue. Crucifier Navy Issue comes in two main flavors. I think the Tracking Disruptor is the most common. Bonuses. Are the Weapon Disruptor bonus, Small Energy Turret Damage bonus, and then Weapon Disruptor range and cost and CPU requirement reductions. You can get a really strong tracking disruptor out of the Crucifier Navy issue, and that's great. But one of the problems that this hull faces is that tracking disruptors are bad if you do not have range control. So if you have range control and you have a tracking disruptor, it does all sorts of good things. You pick where you want to sit at some place that's good for your weapon system and bad for their weapon system, and then you turn on the TD with either a tracking speed script or an optimal range script, and it makes it even worse for their weapon system, and you reap the rewards. The problem is if they have range control, you turn on your tracking disruptor, and then they can fly in such a way that they can minimize the impact of it. So if they're faster than you and you've got a tracking speed script on them, they can fly to minimize traversal, and it doesn't do much. You don't need a lot of tracking if traversals are low. Likewise, optimal range, you put an optimal range script on them and they have less range, but if they can position themselves, then they can position themselves in such a way that the range is less of a hit. The Crucifier Navy issue does not have a great reputation. It's pretty engageable. It's one of the weaker faction frigates, I think, for this reason, and I will often engage it with weaker stuff, hoping for this fit. And then take advantage of the fact that the tracking disruptor doesn't do all that much. And, you know, again, pulse lasers don't have very good tracking already. So maybe I can fly in such a way that this ship has tracking problems and my ship does not, potentially. The other way they can be fit is just completely ignoring the tracking disruptor and fitting double web and beams instead of pulse, and flying it like a tormentor that has two webs. I like that approach a lot more. It also has a little more buffer than the tormentor, but we talked before about how strong a double web tormentor is. The downside is it gives up the scram, and here you can fit double web and a scram. So that's nice. Lots of combat frigates will engage your faction frigate if you're flying one of these because of its not so hot reputation. When I see a Crucifier Navy issue, I tend to guess their fit like this. If you really don't want to lose your ship, you have to think about what will happen if he's double web fit. Because if you're in, I don't know, an Atron, an Executioner, or something fast with a single web, you'll be able to outposition this one, maybe kill it, maybe leave because it's slow. If you can't kill it, this one with the double web, they'll have range control, and you gotta think about how do you feel if you were hoping for this guy and you get this guy. The Imperial Navy Slicer has two mids, and it's real hard to build a standard low set control package. AB Scram Web, we're short of mid. Lots of people fit it to kite. It's got this very nice range bonus, so max skill 50% optimal range and then a big damage bonus. So people put MWDs and warp disruptors on it. It's real common. If you see one of these in faction warfare, they're going to try to enter the plucks and then fire the micro warp drive right as they come in, hopefully as you're locking them, and hopefully they like drift far enough that even if you get the scram, they can drift out of range, and then they get the warp disruptor on you and they just kite around you. You can try to slingshot them. It's real hard with an AB. You don't go very fast. They go pretty fast. If they maintain a good orbit and they're able to get past your scram, that's probably their win. If you catch the scram, you orbit them, the guns absolutely will not track, and they die a slow death, almost regardless of what else your ship is doing. If you can do a bit of damage to them, you have a scram, and you can orbit them, and catch the scram, it's probably a win. Also, sometimes pulse fit, better tracking, still not good enough to track you unwebbed, orbiting in almost any hull. It's a little academic which of these they're in. If you're in a brawl or scram kite fit. And that's the most common Amarr fits that I mostly expect to see when I'm out in faction warfare space. Thank you for watching.